Welcome back to the channel. In today's video we are going to look at the following WWE news and rumors. Zelina Vega joining AEW, Roman Reigns reacts to Seth Rollins' praise, Ric Flair denies being involved in major WWE backstage rumors, The Miz sends a message to all his haters through merchandise, and Paul Heyman says that Seth Rollins is special. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe. Also feel free to let us know what you think about the following news and rumors in the comments section below. Without wasting any time, let's get into it. Paul Heyman reveals his honest thoughts about special Seth Rollins. During the latest edition of Talking Smack, Paul Heyman had some serious praise for Seth Rollins. On this week's Talking Smack, Rollins was a guest and had a lot to say about his current feud with Cesaro. After a brief chat with Paul Heyman, Rollins took his leave. After Seth left, Heyman told Kayla Braxton that his lower back was hurting earlier in the day, but he felt better after shaking hands with Rollins. Heyman then said that there's something special about Rollins. Soon after the show came to an end, Heyman posted a tweet heaping praise on Rollins. Paul Heyman stated that he believes Rollins is someone who benefits SmackDown. Paul Heyman made it clear that he is a big fan of Seth Rollins. He literally said that shaking hands with Rollins made him feel better. After a short hiatus, Seth Rollins returned to WWE at the 2021 Royal Rumble and has established himself as a top heel on the Blue brand. Many believed that Rollins would return as a babyface, but it seems WWE has other plans for his character. Roman Reigns is currently the biggest heel on WWE TV, but Paul Heyman could have his eyes on Seth Rollins. If things remain the same, it won't surprise many if Rollins and Reigns ally somewhere down the line. What are your thoughts on Paul Heyman's major praise of Seth Rollins? Do you want to see the duo aligned soon, leading to Rollins joining Roman Reigns in a mega heel faction? Sound off in the comments. The Miz sends a message to his haters with his new merchandise. The Miz became the new WWE champion at Elimination Chamber, much to the dismay of his critics. Some fans aren't happy with WWE's decision to make the A-lister a world champion. The Miz has responded to the hate by releasing his newest t-shirt on the WWE shop. The Miz sent a clear message to his critics via Twitter, promoting his new merchandise. WWE has released a t-shirt in commemoration of The Miz's historic WWE Championship win. The merchandise features a picture of The Miz hoisting the WWE Championship over his head, as well as the following words written in huge letters, "Hated daily and loving it." It has just been a week since The Miz became WWE Champion, and his reign may already be coming to an end. The A-lister will be defending his title on the upcoming episode of Monday Night Raw, and he isn't exactly favored to win. The reason being that he will be defending the title against the almighty Bobby Lashley. Considering how dominant Bobby Lashley has been so far, everyone expects the Dominator to win. After all, he has taken out the likes of Braun Strowman, Jeff Hardy, and many more on his way to the top. As a result, The Miz's chances of coming out on top in this match seem minimal. What do you think of The Miz's odds against Lashley? Will he be victorious during next week's Monday Night Raw? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. Ric Flair is all over the news these days, as the Nature Boy has tapped into his true self on WWE TV, as part of the Lacey Evans romantic storyline. The WWE Hall of Famer made an appearance on the Wrestling Incorporated Daily podcast, and he was asked about a rumor that has been circulating backstage. Speculation is that Ric Flair has been attending creative meetings in the WWE, however, that is far from the truth. The former WCW champion revealed that he had not been involved in WWE's creative meetings. Ric Flair stated that he likes to offer ideas but has realized, over the years, that it's best for him to go ahead with WWE's plans. No. Absolutely not. I do like to offer suggestions, but I've learned through trial and error that I'm okay just agreeing to everything they've laid out. Ric Flair steps in with his inputs and storylines that he is more involved in, but he has learned to stay away. The ever-changing world of wrestling can't satisfy everyone, and Ric Flair understands that an agent's job can be brutally unforgiving. If at any storyline involves me intricately, I want to give input. But I am better off just listening. This business has changed a lot, you can't make everyone happy. It's a thankless job to be an agent. Ric Flair revealed in a separate interview that he had many big ideas laid out for the storyline with Charlotte and Lacey Evans. However, WWE had to turn him down for one very important reason. Ric Flair has been a featured name on Raw over the past few weeks, but his controversial storyline with Lacey Evans seems to have hit an unforeseen roadblock recently. Lacey Evans announced that she was expecting her second child, and WWE officials were forced to alter all their storyline plans. The creative shift already happened on last week's Raw as Ric Flair was seemingly written off TV, and it may be a while since we see the Nature Boy again on WWE TV. The Trinidad, also known as Zelina Vega, was released from the WWE in November 2020 after disagreements over WWE's third-party edict. Trinidad's 90-day non-compete clause recently came to an end, and there has been a lot of speculation regarding her next destination. Tony Khan was the guest on a recent edition of the Wrestling Observer Radio. The AEW CEO was asked about the possibility of seeing The Trinidad in All Elite Wrestling. Khan was under the impression that Trinidad's 90-day non-compete clause was still active. The AEW boss admitted that he has been waiting for the clause to expire, which seemingly confirmed AEW's interest in the former WWE superstar. Khan said that he would love to see Zelina Vega's status after AEW wraps up the ongoing Women's Title Eliminator Tournament and the Revolution PPV. "Isn't she in a 90-day non-compete? She was in a non-compete last time I checked. I've been waiting for that. I don't talk to people when they have the non-compete. If hers is expired, it must have just expired. I've been waiting on her non-compete to expire. I'd have to check the math to see if she expired. When we get through this tournament and through this pay-per-view, I'd be interested to see where she's at." Trinidad had dropped a possible AEW Dynamite teaser recently, and while she didn't appear on AEW's flagship show, all roads still point towards the former WWE star being All Elite very soon. On this week's episode of Talking Smack, Paul Heyman revealed Roman Reigns' reaction to Seth Rollins' latest comments about him. Paul Heyman and Seth Rollins had an interesting discussion about Rollins' current feud with Cesaro on WWE SmackDown. While talking about Cesaro, Heyman had a message to share with Seth Rollins from none other than the tribal chief, Roman Reigns. "I must admit to you that my tribal chief Roman Reigns has seen the media that you've done recently. It's quite impressive. Roman Reigns is quite flattered by the words that you have bestowed upon him, which makes me a special counsel constraint. It's not because I think Cesaro is more of a man than you are, but he is on such a tier lately. He has finally stepped into a zone that he has never been able to find before. That zone makes him, with his superhero strength, one of the most dangerous competitors in WWE. Fans might remember that Seth Rollins recently heaped praise on Roman Reigns while talking with WWE's The Bump. Rollins and Reigns have a ton of history together, going way back to 2012. Absolutely killing the game, he's doing incredible things as the head of the table, the Universal Champion, representing SmackDown, as good as he can. It's really an incredible thing to watch someone really take hold of their own belief system of their own career," said Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins is still a heel following his return to WWE and is currently feuding with Cesaro on SmackDown. Many fans are hoping that Rollins and Cesaro get to have a singles contest at WrestleMania 37. Roman Reigns, on the other hand, is hands down the biggest bad guy in all of WWE. The tribal chief turned heel at SummerSlam 2020 in one of the most surprising moments in recent memory. Fans had been wanting to see a heel Roman Reigns for a long time at that point, and WWE finally decided to do the unthinkable. Reigns then aligned with Paul Heyman, who was his arch rival at one time. Ever since, Roman Reigns has been wreaking havoc on WWE SmackDown and is all set to battle Edge of the Show of Shows with his Universal Championship on the line. Now that fans know what Roman Reigns thinks of Seth Rollins, one can't discount the possibility of these two former friends reuniting in the near future and forming one of the most dominant factions in WWE history.